Hey guys, Brian here, Brian's Lawn Maintenance. Hey, trust you guys are doing well. Hey, hope you guys are having a great day. Hey, wanted to come at you with a cool, just a couple extra tips, man. These are two different tips I got for getting new customers really simply. And some of them I haven't shared before, so I wanted to just share two of them with you guys really quick. Let's just get into it, make this one short and sweet. A lot of you guys want to talk about adding new customers. And by the way, this video is being shot September 28th, 29th of 2017. So we're in the fall. So this video will probably be relevant still in the spring when a lot of us are looking at videos and trying to learn how to grow our business, get new customers. Pretty popular topic, obviously, in the spring, right? But in the fall, you can still be gaining customers all year round, guys. Many of you guys know that. I don't think there's any problem with adding customers anytime as long as you're proactive, you're hungry, you have some goals, you know what you're trying to accomplish. But anyway, I picked up a new client just the other day, and I also wanted to give you a tip that I use for a long time. What I wanted to do is share two thoughts for you guys. One is how to get new customers over time. Now, this is one of my big secrets, is that it's not really a secret, but it's just kind of common sense, but a lot of merit behind this one. Most of you guys know that when you're trying to pick up new clients in a lot of these nicer subdivisions, they may already have a service, or that homeowner that currently owns that lot doesn't want lawn service, so you can't really get that person as a customer. What I would tell you is that folks who stay in the game long term are more likely to pick up more customers, just almost like in any other industry. Those who stick around tend to get new customers. And why do I say that with lawn care? Well, the average mortgage, from what I heard and what I understand, for a residential home is 7 years, which means every 7 years people are cycling in and out of that home. And I kind of changed my attitude and philosophy with looking at homes and getting customers, and I look more at the property now just as much as I do looking at the actual customer. Well, what does that mean? Well, let's say you have a house, 125 First Street, right? And I know I've cut that lawn for a few years. Well, let's say that homeowner decides to sell that house and a new homeowner moves in. I always try to have my customers leave my business card, leave a letter of recommendation for me, and then when that new customer moves in, boom, I've got 125 First Street again. Now, I might have that customer for 5 or 6 years until they decide that maybe they have two kids, the home isn't going to be adequate for them, it's too big, it's too small, and then they want to sell that home. And you guys would be surprised at how fast people cycle through these homes. Even though people take out 30-year mortgages, based on life, based on family, based on having kids, more kids, kids growing up, moving out, moving in, all that kind of stuff, people are not actually living in these homes as long as you guys may believe, especially when you take out a 30-year mortgage. So after 5 years, they have their second kid, it's a 3-2, now they want a 4-3 with some land or by the lake, so those people move out, and another starter family moves in, and the same thing. So I had to change my attitude where, if I don't have a client or a house or a customer right now, or maybe somebody else does, it's okay, because within a few short years, there's a better chance that I'm gonna get that customer or that account by just sticking around. Here's the thing, I've been doing this now for 10 years cutting grass, and I've seen two or three different people move into homes or lots that I've cut. And I've cut three different homeowners in a row now. I've cut the lawn, another family moves in, I lose the account, obviously, because they don't want me for whatever reason, or they're just cutting it on their own, and then they move out, another family moves in. I always introduce myself and say, hey, I used to cut that property for a long time, are you guys interested in a service? Boom. So I might have it for 3 years, lose it for 3 years, gain it back for 3 years. So one of my big tips is, it's just kind of a timing thing. Those who stick around in the business long term, another thing is, the average guy who cuts grass, or the average business owner, I should say, most businesses fail with what? In the first 5 years. So that means 80% of people that are around right now cutting grass won't even be in business more than likely 5 years from now. So if you don't have that customer as one of yours right now because somebody else is using another service, well, here's a tip. That guy might be in his fourth year and he might be out on his fifth. He might be in his first year and he's gonna have that client for a few years. No big deal. I'm gonna outlast him, because when that guy goes out of business, I'm gonna take those customers. And here's another tip, 80% of the businesses that make it past the first 5 years, they're out within the first 10 years. So that means anybody who's left over, some of those long-term guys, hey, you know what, eventually they're gonna fade away as well. So it's one of those cool opportunities where if you just outlast, whether it's the homeowner or the other business owner, more than likely you're going to be able to pick up that business. So those are my two tips, those are my two ideas for you guys, is outlast the business owners, and outlast the homeowners, because that lot, that's what I think more now. I think, hey, the lot at 125 First Street or whatever, the same home that you guys are always thinking, I'm thinking, hey, I take care of that lot. You just happen to live at that home. And it's kind of a different thing. I'm not saying I'm entitled to that property, obviously, guys. I'm not saying that I own that lot or anything like that. I just kind of think like, hey, there's a lot of earth that I manage. There's a lot of property that I manage. And whether you come or go, it's really no big deal, because I know you're going to come or go owning that house. And you know what? I might have that house for 5 years. That person might sell. They might move out. They might start renting, whatever, somewhere else, and I'm gonna get that client back if I happen to lose them for 2, 3, 4 years. And that's just perspective, man, after doing this for 10 years. So hopefully that helps you guys out a little bit. Just thinking about sticking around long term, you're gonna get a lot more of those customers if you're one of the people that outlast. It's really a timing issue. So hopefully those one or two tips helped you guys out. What are some of your guys' thoughts? Sincerely, I'd love to know what you guys have for thoughts about getting new customers and sticking around. Have you guys noticed that you've been able to pick up more customers long term the longer some of you guys have been in business? Maybe you see some of these other companies go out of business, or they scale back, or they stop doing lawn care and they phase into only landscaping, or vice versa. Or maybe the guy just unfortunately has a life circumstances, he doesn't want to carry on with his business anymore. And as long as you stick it out, you're able to pick up those customers and swoop underneath and take them all from whoever decides to quit or move on. So pretty cool topic, right? But anyway, let me know what you guys' thought. Leave a comment down below. Have you guys picked up any new customers just by sticking it out? I'd love to hear you guys' thoughts. Don't forget, if you guys are new to the channel, we give tips and tricks and business advice like this all the time. So if you guys like videos like this, make sure you click that subscribe button and make sure you become a fan of one of ours. I super appreciate the support. If you guys are already one of our fans and you guys already like the channel, hey, you guys know, don't forget to hit that like button. It means a lot, and I really appreciate the support. So guys, that's pretty much it for me. If you guys enjoyed this one, like I said, make sure you leave it a big thumbs up. Make sure you leave a comment down below. Love to hear your thoughts. If you guys got anything else for me, let me know. But guys, we'll catch up with you on the next one. Thanks again for watching. Myself, Brian, with Brian's Law Maintenance. We'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.